Good evening, welcome back to Bloodborne. We are gonna go deal with the boss of the creepy snake forest, but gotta level up and do some other things first, real quick.
Welcome. Very well.
So most importantly, leveling up. We have 3 levels. No, I'm going to do 1 into Arcane and 2 into Vitality.
Farewell, good hunter. May you find your worth in the waking world.
I need to start boosting my stamina as well. That's going to happen soon. It needs to happen pretty soon. Okay, so real quick. Runes. We have extra Quicksilver Bullets. I kind of like that. 3% extra physical damage reduction. That's not the most important thing ever, so I'd maybe be okay swapping that out if we have something better. I think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna go with the anti-clockwise metamorphosis rune. Also, gonna get me some more Molotovs? Molotovs. Oh, wait. There we go. Phew, controls. They're surprisingly difficult. Make sure that I'm fully stocked up on everything, regardless of whether or not it's something I'm going to be using anytime soon. I got a bunch of weapons put away. Oh, we can, like, store the cannon. I'm not going to be using that. You can check it out real quick. Large prototype firearms fashioned by the workshop heretics, the powder kegs. Use of this weapon is equivalent to toting a mounted cannon complete with its ridiculous weight, staggering kick, and lavish use of quicksilver bullets into battle. Such a monstrosity was doomed from the start, and indeed its development was cut short. Yet, against impossibly gigantic foes, it might be just the thing. It uses 12 quicksilver bullets, and it requires 30 strength and 13 dex to wield. And by dexterity, I mean skill. And it shall never, ever be used. No need to store any of this other armor and stuff we got going on here. I could start depositing some of these runes, like the ones that I'm never going to use. I might just do that. I'm not going to use you. Probably not going to use you, but never say never. Alright, well, that was eventful. Let's swap out some runes real quick. So more blood echoes, I really like that. Increased defense, I think we're gonna change you to more stamina? That seems more useful to me. 10% extra stamina, and I'm at what? 110-ish, 120-ish? So yeah, I'm a fan of that. I'm a big fan of that. With that, we have some other things to do. I might hop around and do some of these other things real quick. So let's head back to the first floor sick room. These are all just little things that I've been meaning to do and I keep forgetting, and I'm thinking of some of them now, so we'll do some of them now.
Oh, well, hello. Splendid. Let me ask you a small kindness. You're soon off to hunt, I presume? Then, if you find any survivors, tell them to seek Yusefka's clinic. Upon my Hippocratic oath, if they are yet human, I will look after them. Perhaps even cure them. This sickness, these beasts, they are not to be feared. This time the night is long. I may be trapped here, but I should do something to help. I'll even offer a reward for your cooperation. Tempted? Well, off you go then. If you find anyone, you can please.
Okay, so we have another place where we could potentially send people.
If you find Euclid.
I think something happens if you keep attacking the door.
Can't anyone comprehend? That'll be quite enough of you, then. Isn't it time someone put you out of your misery?
Oh, and I can't talk to her anymore now. I pissed her off. She's maybe not as nice and cheerful as she seems. She's definitely not as nice and cheerful as she seems. Okay, we'll be dealing more with her in the future. I just wanted to do that. While I'm here, there is this big, tough, scary-looking enemy. I never really came back here and dealt with him. Not you. You are not the big scary enemy. This is the big scary enemy. So we'll just finish him off real quick. One of the executioners. Okay, well, that was not what I wanted to have happen. That's fine. I'll take that hit. That's okay. Let's see. I thought he had an item back here? Apparently I was mistaken. Well, that's fine either way. There are just like a couple things in the area on my list. I want to go find the lady and the guy across the street who didn't trust me. And tell them both of a safe place where they can go hang out. We also haven't talked to our friend here in quite a while.
Have I heard of Byrgenworth? Afraid I can't say that I have. The locals aren't apt to share any local history. I'm afraid I may not be of help for much longer.
Okay. Well, we'll come back and talk to him after we deal with Byrgenworth. Let's see. I would like to get back to Gascoigne's house, where Gascoigne's daughter was. Forget whether we do the next part of that quest now or after another certain story event happens. So we're just gonna go check on that real quick. And I'll probably edit out some of this transit time. Actually, we can just go down here. I'd rather not deal with the pig. Nothing else here is really worth wasting my time on. Those crows still make the worst noises. I pretty strongly believe that this thing that I want to do isn't available until we progress the story a little bit further. Until after Byrgenworth, basically. But I'm here, so we may as well check it. So, let's check. Is there anybody here? No response. Okay, that's unfortunate. I should probably just bolt Hunter's Mark and get out of here. We'll go fight the boss now. I'll go find the... Because I don't remember exactly where those people are, so I'll go find the lady and the guy across the street. Off camera. Like, I'll record myself doing it, and then I'll just stick it at the end of this video or something. Alright. Another thing that I would like to wrap up is the NPC that I think we bumped into right at the end of the last video. He's here-ish in the forest area, and he's, like, eating the corpse of a small child while huddled around the rest of the dead family. I think we can do him after the boss, though. Yeah, I think we just need to do him before Byrgenworth. Before we're finishing Byrgenworth. Not, like, before getting to Byrgenworth or anything. Darn it. Stupid snake men. Okay, so we got them. We have, like, two pigs that we're gonna have to fight, a couple of other enemies. Not that big of a deal, but just there are enemies in our way here. Hello, pig. So effective. Oh, it's so effective. I think it's funny considering just how much difficulty I was having at the very beginning of my Bloodborne playthrough here, that, I think it's safe to say I've gotten my rhythm back. I think it's safe to say that I'm doing alright now. Doing alright. So, beckoning bell. Let's see if I can summon an actual person to assist. Because if so, that's great. And if not, that's also just fine, because we can ring the hunter's bell, the old hunter's bell, at that place. And at the other one up here. So let's go... try and free this one up. There is one of those snake enemies up here that I gotta deal with. Cool. Hooray! Bellring Woman has appeared somewhere also, so that's another thing to be aware of. Confederate Nick! Hello! A little conviction there. Got some nice church garb. We're gonna wait for the younger Madara's twin to show up, and boss time. This fight is rough, by the way. Cause we gotta fight the three shadows of Yharnam. So I've got the close range one, there's a medium range and a long range. And I'm assuming my two friends are gonna take care of the other two shadows. And they also... oh, well, the younger twin is gone. Yep, they're also all snake people, as you might expect, given everything else that's happening in here so far. And, yeah, now things get a little tougher. because they got, like, yo-yo snake arms. And he's got a fire sword. Oh, they took out the long-range guy first, though, which is great. And if we can kill this guy quick enough, we don't even have to deal with, like, their third ultimate phase. Yeah, there we go. That was nice and easy. Blood Rapture! Yeah, I'll rally also. I'll agree with that. Hey, dude's got the cleaver. Oh, and he's got the cane, too. Alright. Alright. And, we can just silence the bell. I lost my two insight, I regained my two insight, it's all fine. Sad that the NPC died and was probably completely useless, but if he... You know, if he took the hit so that the other human didn't have to, then that's great. Cool, so yeah, that was a pushover of a boss fight this time around. They were really difficult to do by myself in my original playthrough. I think they more just, like, psyched me out. There were a lot of enemies and that just... I had a hard time kind of, I wasn't very confident in that fight my first time around. Okay, so fire doesn't do squat to you, or at least the chain whip doesn't squat to you. I wonder if just the cane will be helpful. These new creepy bug creatures are new and creepy, and they're awful. They like to jump up in the air and land on your face, and it's not very pleasant, let me tell you. Oh, so, Byrgenworth. This is it. And there's the old hunter that we can summon. Probably equally for clearing out the area as much as for fighting the boss. This is a very, very tiny but fairly dense area. I feel like they're just fire-resistant bugs. Which is... fine. Hello, buddy. Nope. Yep, grabbing my face. Oh, and you're gonna frenzy me. I don't want to be frenzied. I lived through the frenzy, which is pretty good. We have to get to the other side to unlock this gate. That's like our main shortcut here. Yeah, frenzy's like bleeding. We haven't really had to deal with it up till now. I probably want to not be wearing Gascoigne's garb anymore, because I think... Oh gosh darn it. I think it has no frenzy resistance at all. I think that I am, like, ultra stupidly weak to frenzy right now. Okay. Just barely lived through that one again. excuse me. Frenzy resistance. It's kind of important right now. So, 41 for that. 49 for the graveguard robe. 56 for just the regular hunter garb. 8 for the church garb. Sorry, I'm looking at the wrong thing. 9 for the church garb. Yeah, so we'll rock the hunter garb for a little bit. Hunter garb is fine. Then just hunter trousers. Henrik's trousers. This will be fine. Yeah, I feel fine with this. You're dead. So, main goal now is just to loop through the area, open the couple of shortcuts, and then gear up for the boss fight that's going to be happening probably in the next video. So there are I need to run around and make sure that I'm not missing anything. Oh god, it's another one of you. Actually, fire should be stupidly effective against you. After the boss of this area, things change pretty dramatically throughout the rest of the game. So it triggers, like, the next phase of a bunch of quest lines, it blocks off a lot of other quest lines, it changes NPC interactions, it changes a significant chunk of the world. Can we get in from this side, or is this only out? Yeah, okay. So I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything significant before we move on. Look at that moon, by the way. That's pretty cool. That's pretty darn cool. Alright, there's one or two up on the bridge, I believe. And then there's that thing. There you are. And I was right, it was two. Don't want to be frenzied again, that's bad. Oh, you wretched little creatures. Yes, so I fought a couple of these way back in Chalice Dungeons. It's the weird fangly tooth flower spider monster. It shoots fireballs. That place is death. But here's our shortcut. We can run through the building. Like, into the building is where we ultimately need to go. There's a one-time, like, mini-boss enemy. It's another hunter. Kind of. We need to kill her. And then she won't respawn. But, she's a really tough customer, so it might be kind of difficult. I don't know. Got the shortcut opened up. I'm gonna kill the fangly flower thing. It spits fire, so I don't know if fire is gonna be very effective against it. Answer's no. But the Tomatress is not terribly effective either. Luckily, those things are really, really easy to fight. You get close. Oh, and did he not drop an item? Did his head fall over the ledge or something? Probably. That's okay. Great One's Wisdom! That is like a super madman's knowledge. That is a madman's knowledge on steroids. Let's take a look at that real quick, because it's fun. And then again, part of the whole, like, item progression thing. Like, oh, you got one squiggle coming out of your cracked skull forehead? How about all the squiggles from the entire face with, like, little, they're like little weird little slug things? Yeah, that's like one slug. That's a lot of slugs. So this is Fragments of the Lost Wisdom of the Great Ones, things that might be described as gods used. To gain insight, at Byrgenworth, Master Willem had an epiphany. We are thinking on the basest of planes. What we need are more eyes. Yep. Preferably, you want more eyes on the inside. Alright, so when I come in here, the NPC is gonna start trying to ruin my life. She is up above. I don't think she'll actually start attacking until we get onto the stairs. Pearl Slug. Is that a ritual thing? It is. Of all the strange life forms that reside in the nooks and crannies of the old labyrinth, the slugs are clear signs of the left-behind Great Ones. That's great. Sage's Wrist, have we looked at this before? Body part of a saint, sanctified by the Healing Church in their search for truth. Oh yeah, it boosts the Watchers. Arcane Haze, the tiny smatterings of haze that are found in certain ritual materials, sometimes required for special rites. The additional rite, Sinister Bell, makes the bell-ringing woman appear, and when she rings a Sinister Bell, hunters from other worlds will be beckoned in as adversaries. So yeah, that's a chalice thing, where the chalice, instead of just summoning, like, the red enemies, maybe in addition to, I'm not entirely certain, the bell-ringing woman will summon actual invaders, other people playing the game, to come try to ruin my life. Oh, and I want to check out the rune that we got here, too. Arcane Lake, so boosts arcane defense. It's like a middle tier rune. It's pretty well defined, so that's great. Yeah, we've already read the item description for these. So the basic dissipating lake, like for bolt defense, is 5%. This one is arcane damage reduction of 7%. It might not be a bad idea to equip it. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna regret this. Hello there, I see you. Yep, she uses the chain whip. It's her other weapon, which is, like, particularly devastating. That. Oh, get me out of here. That thing. I don't like that thing. Oh, my weapon's at risk, so this is bad. She also does that. That's the thing that I'm really scared of. It's okay, though. Oh, you're so much tougher to fight without the Taunitress. It's okay. It's just gonna take a little while, but we got this. You're easy enough to beat if I can just get close. Yep, you also have tentacle arms. Got that. Get me out of here! Get me away! Get me away! There we go. You're almost done. Get her, get her, get her, get her! Oh, thank goodness. Whew. Three blue elixirs. Alright, we're almost done with this whole area, so let's just finish clearing it out. Oh my gosh, we got another bell to ring. Henrik again. We got the student uniform. Oh my gosh, there's another person. Damien of Mensis. Ooh. There's a note. When the red moon hangs low, the line between man and beast is blurred. And when the great ones descend, a womb will be blessed with child. Yeah, that's kind of creepy. I'm curious to know who the other person was that we could maybe have summoned just outside. So we got the Lunarium key. That's the key that we need to open that big door that we were just next to. There is also one last bug creature up here. And I'm not going to be able to Taunitress him to death. And I'm not going to be able to get him down with the pebble either. Hey, buddy. Nope. Walk on, please. Camera. Come on. Camera, don't fight me in this. We also get treasure. What do we get? The empty phantasm shell. I'm actually considering making that a thing. Could do that. I'd have to get rid of the fire on my weapon, though. It's a buff. It will burn quicksilver bullets. Here, we can just take a look at it. It's a magic thing, right? So it's in this category with the old hunter bone and the beast roar. So an empty shell that applies arcane power to your weapon. So you use three quicksilver bullets and you go bong and you put arcane power on your weapon for a short period of time. But I don't think you can buff things that already have some sort of element or additional effect of their own. There's like a, there are a couple of weapons I'm thinking of in particular later on in the game that this would not apply to. Just like the Taunitress, this will not apply to the Taunitress. It already does thunder damage. I don't think it'll apply to my fire cane either. So, empty invertebrate shell that is said to be a familiar of a great one. The Healing Church has discovered a great variety of invertebrates, or phantasms, as they are called. Shells with slime still harbor arcane power and can be rubbed on weapons to imbue them with their strength. So that's a thing. Now this is... This kind of leads to the boss fight, but I'm not gonna do the boss fight just yet. Right, because this video's going long, but we'll talk to this guy. We saw him. This is Master Willem. We saw him in the cutscene. When we learned the password to Byrgenworth. He was the one who was saying, "By the gods, fear the old blood, Lawrence. Fear it. Fear it good." He gave me some insight, and he's pointing to that way. Up there, maybe, where we can go look at the moon. Now, I don't think there's any benefit to actually leaving him alive. Andy is really creepy. He drops a pretty okay rune that I don't know that I'm going to be using, but maybe I will. Oh. Nah, we'll leave him alive for now, but he does drop a decent rune. I may come back and revisit that decision in the future. So, everything's cleared out. We're gonna have to fight like 2 or 3 bug creatures on our way. Oh, I went out the wrong door. It doesn't matter. We're gonna have to fight like 2 or 3 bug creatures on our way in back into that building. We're gonna go through the shortcut on the other side, though. Because that's a much better thing to do. I would like to see who this person is at this bell. Just, I'm curious to know if it's gonna be the older twin, since we encountered the younger one before the last boss. Nope, the younger Madara's twin, again. I wonder if and when we're gonna encounter the older twin. That's kind of curious. Anyway, back to the Hunter's Dream, level up, all that stuff, and then we can wrap the video up. I desire level ups. Okay. Now, I want to keep putting points into the vitality. Let's just do that. It's at 30. That's 1100 HP. That's a pretty good amount. I feel pretty good about that. And then I'm going to continue raising my arcane. I want to get that to 30. And I want to start bumping my endurance up to 30 as well. It might be worth it to upgrade my strength again. The Taunitrous is a strength-based weapon, so it scales pretty significantly based off of your strength, right? Like, 1 point there gives us 3 extra attack power on the Taunitrous. 1 point of Arcane gives us 1 point of damage on the Taunitrous, but it has the Arcane has a greater effect, you know, when we light up the Taunitrous, and it also affects the Fire Whip a fair bit now as well. But yeah, Vitality for now. Endurance and Arcane are going to be my next couple of priorities. After that, let's go repair my slowly breaking weapon. I forgot just how much, like, how fragile the Taunitrous is. Kind of unfortunate, but, you know, that's a fairly effective drawback to the thing. I really wish we had more bloodstone chunks. We'll be getting those soon enough, but I don't like waiting. I do not like waiting for those. I guess I'm gonna buy some more Hunter's Marks. It's good to stay stocked up on those. Before we do the boss, I'm not necessarily going to do the boss in the next video. There are a few things that, like I've been mentioning, we're going to run around and take care of before that happens. Actually, Dark Beast Parle, I think we're going to go deal with that boss. Because I'm fairly certain that's something that might become inaccessible later? Maybe not inaccessible. I don't know. Anyway, I'll figure out what we're going to do next time. Thank you all for joining me, and may the good blood guide your way.